In the previous lecture, we discussed characteristics of equilibrium constant, and in that we discussed that the only experimental factor which influences equilibrium constant is the temperature. Okay, so first we discuss the variation of equilibrium constant with the temperature. It is given by Van 't Hoff, so this is also called Van 't Hoff equation. Okay, so first one is, see, according to the Arrhenius equation, rate constant K equal to frequency factor into exponential of minus Ea by RT. What is Ea here? Activation energy. A is a frequency factor and it is a rate constant. Already we made a video on the Arrhenius equation. You can refer that one if you have any doubts. Okay, so here just we are taking this equation. Now, for the forward reaction, if you apply this one, forward reaction rate constant equal to AF, frequency factor for the forward reaction, into exponential of minus Ea of forward reaction by RT. Okay, activation energy of forward reaction by RT. For the backward reaction, from this Arrhenius equation, frequency factor of backward reaction into exponential of activation energy of backward reaction by RT. Okay, so activation energy of backward reaction by RT. So now we know that equilibrium constant equal to forward reaction rate constant by backward reaction rate constant, which already we discussed in the equilibrium constant derivation. Yes or no? Equilibrium constant equal to forward reaction rate constant by backward reaction rate constant. If we substitute here these two, so we get AF by AB. Okay, AF by AB into exponential of, see here we have activation energy of forward reaction by RT. Okay, activation energy of forward reaction by RT by exponential of activation energy of backward reaction by RT. Okay, if you take this into the numerator, so we get equilibrium constant equal to, okay, simply I am emitting this one, just we are writing K. Okay, so AF by AB into exponential of, see, if it comes into the numerator, this becomes plus, right? So we can write activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by RT, we can write. Okay, after simplifying this one, RT is again here, 1 by RT is common. So overall we get activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by RT, we can write. Okay, so this is the equilibrium constant. Okay, so now let us assume that we have two temperatures, okay, T1, and at this temperature equilibrium constant is K1, and another temperature T2, and at this temperature equilibrium constant equal to K2. Okay, so at a lower temperature T1 we are assuming equilibrium constant is K1, at a higher temperature T2 we are assuming equilibrium constant equal to K2. Okay, so from this, if you write at this temperature equilibrium constant K1, at temperature T1 equal to activation energy of forward reaction by activation energy of backward reaction into exponential of activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by RT1. So no, for this formula, see, for this formula we are applying this one, at equilibrium constant K1 at a temperature T1. This is the equation from this. Similarly, at temperature T2 we can write K2 equal to, okay, AF by AB into exponential of activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by RT2. So no. Okay, so we can write this equation here. At temperature T2, this is the equilibrium constant K2. Okay, clear? Now let us take K2 by K1. Okay, K2 by K1. So if you substitute these values there, See here, K1 and K2 both have AF by AB, here also AF by AB. So those two will get cancelled. So finally here we have exponential of, see here we have activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by RT2, okay, RT2 by exponential of activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by RT1. Okay, so now if you take it into the numerator and after all simplifications, we get exponential of activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by R into 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. Okay, 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. See here, this term is common in these two and R is also common. So when we are taking it out, and if it goes up, it will become minus 1 by T1. Yes or no? So we are getting 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. Okay, so now if you apply logarithm on both sides, we get ln K2 by K1 equal to, okay, ln K2 by K1 equal to, so ln and exponential, so we get cancelled, so we get activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction by R into 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. Okay, 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. And here we have a one important relation is that enthalpy of reaction equal to activation energy of forward reaction minus activation energy of backward reaction. Very very important relation. Okay, delta H equal to activation energy of forward reaction minus activation energy of backward reaction. If you substitute here, but see here we have activation energy of backward reaction minus activation energy of forward reaction. So here we get minus of delta H by R into 1 by T2 minus 1 by T1. Okay, clear? This is the relation. But here we have the reverse relation, so that's why we are getting minus of delta H. Okay, if you multiply this minus these two terms, then we get, therefore, ln K2 by K1 equal to delta H by R into 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. Okay, this is multiplied by with minus, so we get, so here 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. So no, minus into plus becomes minus, minus into minus becomes plus, so that's why we are writing in this way. Now, if it is converted into logarithm based n, see here ln means base is e, yes or no? Log means base is 10. So log K2 by K1 is equal to delta H by 2.303 R. Yes or no? Ln equal to 2.303 log. So we get 2.303, here we are taking, so delta H by 2.303 R to 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2. Okay, so this is the Wanthoff equation which gives variation of equilibrium constant with temperature. Very very important formula. Okay, see this derivation I am giving to understand how it is derived. Okay, so for the mains level and the NEET level, just you can remember this formula also. Okay, so directly they will give problems. If you remember the formula, you can substitute here in this one. Okay, and this derivation is just to know how we are getting this formula. Okay, clear? And this is integral form. Okay, it is the integral form of Wanthoff equation, and the differential form will be dln k by t equal to, sorry, dln k by dt equal to delta h by rt square. Okay, so this is the differential form. This is the integral form, and the differential form is dln k by dt equal to delta h by rt square. Okay, so differential form. Okay, so now let us see here, this delta H will influence the dependence of K on T that we discuss now. Okay. Now, let us see, we have three possibilities. Okay, so when delta H may be 0, delta H may be greater than 0, that is positive value, or delta H may be less than 0, that is negative value. Okay, so here, first case, let us see this one. Suppose in this equation, when delta H equal to 0, means this entire value will be 0, yes or no? 0 into anything, that is 0. Okay, so total value will be 0, therefore we get log k2 by k1 is equal to 0, right? This we can write log k2 by k1 is equal to log 1, yes or no? Log 1 based on equal to 0, so 0 is not equal to log 1. So if you apply anti-logarithm, log will get cancelled, so finally we have k2 by k1 equal to 1. That implies k2 is equal to k1. Okay, so k2 is equal to k1. What is the meaning of this one? K1 is the equilibrium constant at low temperature. K2 is the equilibrium constant at high temperature. So here both the values are same. Means, is temperature is showing any effect? No. If temperature shows any effect, then k2 value should be definitely different from the k1 value. But here k2 is equal to k1, means temperature does not show any effect when delta H equal to 0. Therefore, we can write when delta H is equal to 0, then k value is independent of temperature, right? Okay, so whenever delta H is not equal to 0, in that case only temperature shows its effect on the equilibrium constant. Very, very important condition. Okay, so right, next. So now, when delta H is greater than 0, that is delta H is a positive value. In this case, see here, this value is positive. This is lower temperature, it is higher temperature. So this value also will be definitely positive only. So entire value will be positive here. Okay, so in this case we get log k2 by k1 is greater than 0. So no, always this is greater than 0. Simple, suppose T1 is 3 Kelvin, T2 is 5 Kelvin. Okay, see here we get 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5, means see only this term I am writing. So here we get that is equal to 15. 5 minus 3, that equal to 2 by 15. Yes or no? Whatever it may be the value, that is positive only. Okay, clear? So very simple. Definitely this is positive. So it is positive. All are positive. Means this entire value will be positive. That is greater than 0. So from if you write in this way, log k2 by k1 is greater than log 1. So finally we get therefore k2 by k1 is greater than 0. Okay, sorry, greater than 1. Therefore, K2 is greater than K1. K2 is greater than K1. Right? Okay, so here, whenever delta H is greater than 0, means what is that reaction? That is nothing but endothermic reaction, right? When delta H greater than 0 means endothermic reaction. In that case, see here, which is greater? Equilibrium constant at higher temperature is greater than equilibrium constant at lower temperature. What is the meaning of that one? When you increase the temperature, equilibrium constant also increases when the reaction is endothermic reaction. Okay, so therefore we can write when delta H greater than 0, that is positive, means in an endothermic reaction, with the increase in temperature, okay, with the increase in temperature, K value increases. Yes or no? Okay, see here, K at higher temperature is greater than K at low temperature is nothing but when you increase the temperature, K value also increases. Okay, so this is the second case in endothermic reaction. So opposite to this one in endothermic reaction, if you decrease the temperature, what happens? Equilibrium constant value decreases. Okay, next here, final case is when delta H less than 0, means when delta H is negative. So here, this is positive, 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 but it is negative. So minus into positive, plus. So this entire value will be now negative. Yes or no? Delta H is less than 0 means this is exothermic reaction. Yes or no? In the exothermic reaction, then log K2 by K1 is less than 0. Yes or no? Log K2 by K1 is less than 0. Here greater than 0 because entire value is positive. Here it is less than 0 because this entire value is negative. Okay, so clear? So now in this case, we can write therefore in the similar way, K2 by K1 is less than 1, therefore K2 equal to K1. Okay, K2 equal to K1. Okay, sorry, K2 is less than K1, not equal to K1. K2 is less than K1. Okay, so here K2 is less than K1 means the equilibrium constant at higher temperature is less than equilibrium constant at lower temperature, right? Okay, so what is this one? Means when a reaction is exothermic, okay, so at higher temperature, as you increase the temperature, K value decreases. So therefore we can write, when delta H is less than 0, that is negative, that is the reaction is exothermic, in this case, with the increase in temperature, okay, with the increase in temperature, K value decreases. Yes or no? K value decreases. This is at high temperature, this value is at low temperature. Okay, so these are the three cases how K value changes with the change in temperature. Okay, when delta H equal to 0, K value is independent of temperature. When delta H is greater than 0, means if the given reaction is endothermic reaction, as you increase the temperature, K value also increases. When delta H is less than 0, means in exothermic reaction, when temperature is increased, K value decreases. Okay, clear? So in the next lecture we discuss how equilibrium constant changes with the change in the stoichiometric coefficients or by the changing the mode of writing of the reaction. Okay, thank you.